DJMTV. Country people, una welcome to DJMTV weekly Pidgin English news. I beg, if this one are the first time when you don't think they see us, make you subscribe and follow us for our social media platforms. For website, now www.djntv.news. Make you subscribe there, because now there will be summer 24/7 news, no shaking. Then for our YouTube, now be DJNTV. Make you subscribe there too. Then make you not forget to knock your hand for the notification bell. Sake of say, as you knock your hand, anytime we knock this come out, you go always receive one straight and direct for your phone. Again, make you like our page for Facebook, now DJMTV. Then make you not forget to follow us for Twitter, now see DJMTV.
Impromptu press conference. You know, even though we had the press invited for our event today, it was supposed to have a larger space in a grander style. But even though they diminish our space, they cannot diminish the idea that we are going to share here. You know, the things that we control are the things that we must control. There's some things that are out of our hands. We must not see that as defeat, but as more fuel to the fire that is propelling us forward to liberate ourselves from the tyranny that is the Nigerian situation today. I'm sitting down here with members of all the progressive organizations and all the companies that I have been working with for years now, a decade almost, some people together here. You know, some people have been in the struggle even when me I was 10 and just growing up. You know, organizations that are on our banner to launch the movement of the people. The movement of the people being an alliance of all progressive organizations, socialist progressive, because that is the underlying ideology here. We are all Pan-Africanist socialists. And this was our own way of announcing this new movement that was going to bring about political opposition to our ruling elites, both business and political. But 2 days ago, my sister called me that she had just been called by members of the Nigerian police force that I can no longer do the event at the shrine because they are threatening to close the African shrine if I do it there. So I'm like, there's no constitutional backing for such a thing. Like, we have the freedom of association. Even if right now they are saying protest is national security, they cannot stop citizens from meeting with one another. This is another level. You know, it's not like people going on the streets, they want to do things. This is us in a private space saying we want to hold a meeting about our own future as citizens of this country. You know, it just shows the level of disrespect that this Mohammed's regime has stood to. It's obvious from what happened 3 weeks ago that we, the middle class of Nigeria, we, the professionals of Nigeria, have seen that the poor of this country have finally realized that we are the conduit of oppression to them. Because we are the bankers that launder their money. We are the police and soldiers that oppress them. You know, it is through us that the conduit of these oppressors, the tyranny, the oppression, gets to the poor people of this country. We are the real estate agents that price housing away from them. We are the lecturers that corrupt the universities. We are the VCs that pass, you know, all kinds of oppressive policies on students in universities. Okay, they've seen that we are the journalists that continue to parrot the narrative of the oppressors. So when they will rise up against the oppressor, they are going to come through the people of this country. They are going to come through the professional and middle class. Just the way oppression has come through us to get to them. So it is our duty to begin to align with our people, to let the oppressors of this country know that they no longer enjoy the allegiance of the working class and professionals of Nigeria. that we that have been able to afford a little bit of comfort within this oppressive state are willing to dedicate our life, our time, and those meager resources towards the upliftment of our brothers and sisters all over this country. You understand? So this for me is the basic premise that the movement of the people has been built on. A little bit of historical background, as everybody knows, the movement of the people was the political statement my father tried to make in the 70s, and they refused to register the party. Going to make his political statement at the polls, maybe you'll not see any of these faces here as candidates, because we would have politicized the Nigerian people enough, we would have woken them up enough to understand and to realize that leadership is in their own hands, their future is in their own hands. The ideas that will liberate Nigerian people might not be on this table, but I want to guarantee you that this movement will be the movement to cultivate those minds, to cultivate those ideas, you know, in the Pan-Africanist and socialist foundation. They had their own rally at Kafar Balewa Square, only 80,000. The MOP one was 280,000, 200,000 more than the party that went on to win the election. So this is the rebirth of that movement. And the movement cannot survive without the support of the Nigerian professionals and the middle class. We have to do the work now to start to engage those of us in society that have been completely left behind, you know, that have been overlooked. You know, for this government to be able to say whether we are arguing today that somebody died in Lekki or not, is because people, poor people in Nigeria are not recorded anywhere. All the animadiri and beggars that migrate to Lagos, inside which data is their name. If they be, if they are the one, because the people that call protest, everybody had left Lekki.
Yes.
It's not everybody that was in Lekki that had family. Yes. Most of the people there were these people that were waiting for something to happen in their life, that didn't even have a home to go to after coffee was called. So how are we sure? Who will come up for them if they are shot and killed? Who will ask? Who will even know? How many people die in Lagos where there is no protest? They will be on the road, dead body on the road for days. Nobody gets to clean, nobody knows the person, nobody in the area even knows who is on the floor that is dead. So the excuses of our government, you know, we see through all these kind of things. So it is these people that have been completely left behind, ignored and silenced in this country that we are here to speak for, that we are here to unite behind. You understand, this is not a movement that wants to do, that wants to carry the people along. No, this is the movement that is built with the people, that is built for the people and will be run by the people. We want to be able to create a new Nigeria where there are no more special Nigerians that will have to be the leaders. They have to put it in writing, you know, thinking that, you know, they will be too ashamed to write such a thing, you know, that Nigerian citizens can no longer meet in this democratic dispensation. And lo and behold, they actually send the letter. And first of all, the letter is really it is a document that illustrates the destruction, not reduction now, the destruction that is the Nigerian state. You know, first of all, manager is spelled as manger. I'm not joking, I mean, I'll pass it around, you can all see. The grammatical error of the letter, so many things here, it just jump at one as so inept. You know, it's almost laughable. If it wasn't this serious, this is comical. You know, and I'll read the letter just real quick so that you all can get it. Because it's not based on any constitutional or legal, they have no legal backing. Because normally when the police write letter like this, they have to put legal backing to their request. You know, so, but it's not, so they appeal to something, and then it's also a warning. This is a threat. This letter is also officially a threat. Because I don't understand, if PDP is holding a meeting, we didn't say they should not hold meeting. We've seen different elite organizations holding meetings since this thing has started. But the people of Nigeria, we the citizens of this country, must not be allowed to do So, and as I speak with you right now, the police have invaded and occupied the whole of shrine. You know, even though my brother has locked it since morning because he said he doesn't want me to even enter. So he locked it because he didn't want the police to come and lock the shrine. And I understand the sentiment. My family, we've lost a lot already with this movement. So I understand my siblings' sentiments. We're not in the mood to lose more. But they're already there still, right now. You know? Anyway, so I start. Re-mass meeting of a movement of the people, tagged SAS movement, lessons and tasks. I write under the corporate social responsibility. Okay, I'm sorry. I write under the corporate social responsibilities and the unprecedented support to Alausa Police Station about the mass meeting of the movement of the people, tagged NSAS movement, lessons and tasks, which is to emerge. This is not my grammar, please. Which is to emerge on Tuesday, 17 November 2020 by 12 noon, venue African Shrine Ikeja, Lagos State. I want to quickly recall your attention to the recent NSAS protest nationwide, which states the nation in the last 5 weeks and end up being violent, causing multifarious destruction, looting and burning down of government and private properties within the borders of the state, as well as causing deaths and injuries to both security agents and innocent law-abiding citizens, which for me is the reason for them to come and protect us. You understand? Anyway, but I write that such a gathering or meeting planned to be hosted at your venue is not welcome at this perilous time when the security of the nation is not welcome you at this perilous time when the security of the nation is trying to find her foot. Not 1 foot, not 2 feet, but many foot. To stabilize all threats to life and property. To suspect some gathering as any infraction that be event for this gathering will be tagged a deliberate action to sabotage the transition and restoration of the peace in Lagos State by the Lagos State government and the Nigerian Police Force. While counting on your positive and prompt response to this call, the usual cooperation on this regard is highly solicited, please. The Nigerian Police, CSP, Shola, Ola, Omiladi, and whatever his name is.
DJN TV. People don't say no, they don't like us.
Welcome to DJN TV.
DJN TV. DJN TV.
Some of the delegates and ask their questions.
DJN TV.